Tonight on Game Time, so Kyudo. Alright, so this is a Japanese martial art, Japanese art form. Can you tell us more about this, please?
Yes, good evening, Mix. Thank you for having me on this show tonight. As you say, Kyudo is the Japanese way of the bow. So basically, we are shooting, we are aiming and shooting at a stationary target. But the way we are expecting the result is not only if we hit or miss the target, but the process, how we carry out this process to shoot this this arrow.
Marshall, you've been practicing Kyudo for decades now, and you've been based here in the Philippines for quite a number of years, 7 years if not,
yes.
If I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
And you felt the need to bring Kyudo here in the Philippines. Why? So what did you see in Filipinos that are interested to take on this sport?
Well, I saw that Filipinos are interested in Japanese culture, especially the history of the samurai, and also the a certain way to get rid of this anxiety, of this stress of work. And people were really in need to seek for this Japanese way of practicing archery. Not only another form, but also including a spiritual form. So because I had my equipment here in the Philippines, I decided to create the group.
All right.
Yeah, in the Philippines.
So what are the basics? What do you need first? What are the mechanics? What are the equipment?
So we use a very long bow, which is longer than the common bows we use in traditional archery. And we use some arrows which are in aluminium. This bow can be also made of bamboo if the level is quite good enough to be able to use this kind of bow. And to pull the string, we use a glove which has a groove to hook the string to pull.
Okay, so if you mentioned the word spiritual, all about being mental and archery also, but can you expound more, please, on the difference between Kyudo and archery?
Archery is more based on the performance, and Kyudo, like I said later, it's more about the way you carry out the process. So the way we shoot an arrow is with process we call asetsu. It's 8 stages to prepare our body, our posture, to shoot the target. But the technique itself is not enough. We need to combine this technique with a certain aspect of mind. If you sit in front of the target with some weaknesses, it will destroy your ordinary state of mind. So we need to polish our ego to be able to shoot without any desire or fear in the process.
Yes, it's a process. And taking out the ego, taking all the thoughts, the negativity behind. So what do you need to be able to start? Is there a process? Can you expound more on that? Or is just picking it up right away in the, you know, shooting?
So on the beginning, of course, we need to stay focused on the technique itself, to bring the basics for a good posture. But also, we train our members to a certain etiquette to respect. The word "hei" in Japanese is common to all the martial arts, which means respect. You have to be stick to a certain attitude in your practice.
Yes.
You really need to be honest with yourself. You cannot lie to yourself in the attitude and the way you are practicing this activity.
It really starts from oneself. It really starts from within that overall approach, of course, to the sport. But it's fairly new. Only 2 years in the Philippines. Have
yes.
there any been tournaments? How to grow the game? How to grow the sport? Any competitions so far?
Alors, in Kyudo, of course, there is some competitions who are very famous in Japan among high school students. In the Philippines, we have not yet this kind of tournaments because the group is quite new, even if we have some members who have already Kyudo background because they were studying in Japan or they have lived in Japan to be able to start a Kyudo practice. In the future, maybe we will bring this possibility of tournaments, but it is not a very elaborated shame of competition that we can find in archery or in other sports.
But in the absence of the tournaments yet, what are your plans, of course, of growing in the awareness of the sport for more Filipinos to participate in?
We have what we call the dan. It's like a belt in judo or in karate. So every members can go to Japan to pass what we call shinsa, an exam where they will be judged on the form that they have acquired at the level they are trying to make certified.
This is the
plans to have every member coming into this grading to make this level certified by the Japanese sensei.
More than the physical aspect of learning this art form, it is a mental and a spiritual approach. Personally, Marshall, what is the fulfillment of every after practice, every after training on what you get, on how it makes you a better person?
So I might have done my best when I shoot an arrow. Even if I don't hit the target, I must take time to reflect on myself what I have done wrong. And every time I am thinking why I have done wrong and what I should do to do right next time I will shoot an arrow. But not only on my technique, but also on the respect of the etiquette that I did. Was I really free from this desire of willing to hit the target or not? This is the question that I always ask myself after my practice to do better and to go into this self-improvement every time I am practicing.
And of course, of growing the pool, I assume that you are accepting beginners, or how can they be part, or how can your viewers be possibly a part of Kyudo Philippines?
Well, they can contact me through the Kyudo Philippine Facebook page. And of course, I would like to remind our viewers that it's not only another form of archery by practicing Kyudo, but also by willing to acquire this self-improvement by another level of spirituality, self-improvement by this philosophy, this philosophical aspect who goes with the shooting.
All right, so there you have it, Marshall Judy of Kyudo Philippines. Thank you so much for joining us here on the show.
Again.
Thank you.